Libya's interim rulers have announced that the body of Colonel Gaddafi was buried at dawn earlier on Tuesday. It was taken to a secret location in the desert to try and avoid his grave being turned into a shrine for his supporters. Artisa Nisa now joins us live now for more. So Nisa, Gaddafi has finally been laid to rest, but why so much mystery around it?
That's right. Well, like you said, people afraid, the NTC most certainly afraid, that his burial site could become some kind of a shrine. He was buried in the desert at dawn in secret, only four witnesses, all of them swearing on the Quran to never reveal the site of Gaddafi's burial. With that said, a lot of secrecy surrounding this, of course, a lot of mystery still surrounding his death and the way he was killed. It's something not so much being spoken about here in Tripoli and the rest of Libya, but certainly from the outside, people are analyzing about whether or not that was the right way to do it. Some people we've spoken to here saying that he should have been treated as a prisoner of war and put to trial. Now, with him being buried today, it needs to be pointed out that it was completely not in accordance with Islamic law. He was on display for some of those days in a shopping center after being kept in a walk-in refrigerator for days, so people could come by and take a look and see for themselves that Gaddafi, in fact, is dead. You see these pictures coming out of that site with people actually wearing masks because obviously the smell, despite the fact that he was being refrigerated, was getting to the people. Long lines of Libyans waiting to see for themselves that Muammar Gaddafi was finally killed. He's been put to rest now. And some of the first announcements that we're hearing, in fact, from the NTC, we heard some from the head about the fact that he believes that Gaddafi as well should have been kept alive and tried, but also announcements coming out from Mustafa Abu Jalil, one of his first announcements, not about rebuilding the country, about what his party or these officials that will most likely be elected in an election that is being promised in 8 months, but his first announcement that he sees the country moving towards Sharia law, which of course is a very hardline Islamic way of leading the country, and ironic that Gaddafi, in fact, was the way he was killed, these brutal pictures which the whole world watched, and then now with this burial taking place days after his death, is completely the opposite of the way a person, no matter who they are, is supposed to be buried according to Islamic law. So we should hear some analysis about that in the coming days as well. But again, huge challenges ahead for Libya. And while people here are certainly basking in the celebration of Gaddafi's death, few of them, it seems, are really thinking about what that means for the future of Libya.
The cries of liberation are loud and clear.
It looks like a state of euphoria here. I mean, everybody's happy, and even though there isn't no formal, you know, law and order.
But are they ignoring the price paid for freedom in Libya? Some 30,000 civilians are said to have been killed, with 4,000 still missing. This house was one of NATO's misses. A single family lost five people, including children.
They apologized to our government, but no one to us. Who is going to rebuild my house? Who will compensate us for our loss?
Much of the country's infrastructure has been destroyed. Finding water is now a serious challenge in the capital. Many don't have running supplies and try to collect what they can.
I have a family with six kids. We need water to live, and to come here every day and get water is very difficult.
They bombed the electric station in Ben Walid. For 10 days they haven't fixed the problem. At least we can come here for now.
But maybe not much longer.
Before the war, Libya could boast one of the best living standards on the continent, with high life expectancy and low child mortality rates. But after months of heavy bombing and fierce fighting, the country's social and economic achievements have been brutally reversed. Its people now betting on a heavily armed and inexperienced group to govern them through a fresh start in the wake of destruction.
Ali asked us not to reveal his face, fearing he might pay for saying this.
If you talk or say anything positive about Gaddafi, you will have serious problems with the rebels. There is no government, and speaking out will be the end of you.
He tells me if people were truly happy about the end of Gaddafi, And the way he was killed, there would be millions, not thousands, on the streets.
I'm sure some 60 to 70% of the country does not approve of the way Gaddafi was killed. We expected him to be tried as a prisoner of war, not killed like that. And we are told in New Libya there will be justice. He was the head of this country, and there was no justice in the way he was killed. I have no hope for the future.
But it's just the beginning. Don't you think that it could get better with time, that things will take time to change in the country?
I think there will be a lot of fighting in the future. Right now in Jamal and Zawara, there is fighting going on between tribes, and anyone with a weapon has power and can do what they want.
So while many celebrate this new era in Libya's history, people like Ali are quietly bracing for the worst. Anissa Nawe, RT, Tripoli.